DMACC has also added more space downtown. Nurses, paramedics, respiratory therapists, and more are getting hands-on training inside DMACC's Capitol Medical Building.
This is the control room, and the control room actually controls the mannequin from this room, and this is where we voice the mannequin and where we alter the mannequin's physiology. So what we have is a microphone speaker system, so I can hear what's happening in the simulation room, and then I can respond through this microphone as the patient.
What's going on?
Oh, I'm just sick to my stomach.
Okay. Are you having any pain anywhere?
Prior to having this type of learning opportunity, students would maybe see something in a book, you know, so they'd read about a code happening. Here they can actually experience what it's like to be in a code situation, to actually have to do CPR.
So this gives you the background that you need to be able to step foot as a real nurse and feel prepared.
Oftentimes students can't do some procedures or administer some medications in the hospital setting due to liability. So here in the sim lab we can actually offer them those opportunities so that they have those experiences prior to graduation. So for example, if there's a medication that we want the students to have the experience given and they can't do that in the clinical setting, we can let them do that here, see the ramifications of their medication dosage calculations and how that can actually affect the patient.
At a hospital, for example, as an LPN student, I'm not allowed to work with IVs. Here in this lab, they allow us to start IVs, spike those bags, get the drip rates going, push IV meds. So in a hospital, if my patient has those, I step aside and have to let the nurse who's taking care of her do it. This here gives me that opportunity to be the nurse, to not be the student, to be the nurse taking care of the patient.
What really is nice about simulation is they can make mistakes. They can make mistakes in a safe environment and learn from those mistakes that they made. And they can see the ramifications of their errors. That if students can have this type of experiential learning, that it improves patient safety, they become more comfortable with their ability to figure out what's happening with the patient and react upon it much faster.
So I have that knowledge to make me feel confident that I can do my job.